love how the cello makes me feel. When I was 6 years old, I started playing, and before I knew it, I was a senior at the Eastman School of Music, and I didn't know what to do. Somehow, I had lost my joy of music. I turned to my teacher, asking for his advice. He said, "David, look into your heart and follow where it leads." Okay, how do I do that? I went back to my dorm room filled with fear and insecurity. What would I find if I actually did open my heart? Stuffed emotions, repressed feelings, God knows what else. Or maybe nothing at all, I didn't know. So I sat on my bed and made my first attempt at meditation. Somehow I must have gotten lucky because I was able to take my heart and open it just a bit and felt so much brightness. You know, the kind of brightness that helps you realize that everything is going to be okay. I asked that brightness, should I continue on in music? And the answer came not in words, but in a feeling, a vibration, like a note of joy resonating in my heart. I took that as a yes, and I came back to my cello with my joy refreshed and with a burning desire to find out how music inspires this brightness inside. I think you might know what I'm talking about. We talk about a bright inner experience all the time when music and ideas light us up. In fact, we make it sound like there's even a piano living inside of us when we use words like, "Wow, that struck a deep chord in me. I really resonate with that. That rings true." And this resonance that we feel is so much more than an emotional response. It's energy awakening within. I'll always remember a particular concert that really brought this home for me. It was so simple, deep, and meditative. The singer and the songs must have been deeply inspired because I could feel a unique resonance awakening for each of the songs. One brought this joyful, rising energy all the way up through my spine. Another brought a peaceful expansion in the middle of my throat. And yet another took my heart and opened it in ways I had never imagined. Maybe you've felt something like this. Or maybe you felt resonance when you recognized an immediate connection with someone. When you realized, hey, we're on the same wavelength. Sound travels in waves. And being on the same wavelength, being in tune, is literally the key to resonance. When you feel in tune with someone or something, you feel it inside. Resonance begins to stir. Now, I'd like to show you how a cello string begins to stir when it is in tune with another string. When I teach my fourth grade cellists how to play in tune, I ask them to listen and watch this magic trick. I'm going to play a note on one string, which is going to awaken a vibration in these other two strings that I'm not going to touch. You can look right here where my finger is for a little wiggle and listen for the ring. This is called sympathetic resonance, and science calls it a harmonic phenomenon because they can't easily explain the invisible forces that are at work. But when I asked my fourth grade students how they thought it might work, one of them raised her hand and said, "Ooh, the string hears its note and wants to sing along." I thought that was brilliant. So remember that. Sympathetic resonance is a string singing along when it hears its note. Now, speaking of singing, in just a minute, we are going to awaken the strings on this piano using our voices. And in order to do that, we're going to need to sing loud. And since singing in public is kind of scary, please take the sacred vow with me. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I will not judge the quality of my voice. Neither will I judge the voices around me. And will sing out with all my heart. Thank you. Mm. Now, imagine for a moment that you are this piano. Will you please cross your arms in front of you and close yourself off? Believe it or not, this is how this poor piano feels all day long until someone comes along and plays it. All of the strings, except for the upper ones, are muffled by dampers pictured above. So when I reach in there and try to pluck one of these strings, the sound dies. When I lift my, it doesn't have much resonance there. But when I play my finger on the note, the damper lifts off. But then as soon as I lift it, it dies a quick death. However, if I put my foot on this right-hand pedal, it lifts all of the dampers off. So the strings can resonate freely. And freedom sounds awesome. So let's take a minute to see how we can find the best freedom for your voice. Will you please uncross your arms, sit up and roll your shoulders back, and let's warm up. Simply hum a note with me. Good. Now, it doesn't matter what note you hum and sing as long as it is loud and resonant. So now we'll take that hum and then open it into an ah, like this. Nice. Now, if there are any singers in the audience, will you please, if there are any singers in the audience, will you please feel free to sing an octave higher or a note in harmony? One more practice. Okay, now, what we're going to be listening for is a very faint resonance that's going to be coming from the piano strings. So I'm going to get one more microphone to set up for this. Now, I've never done this before, so please sing out with all of your heart, and we're going to see if this works. So my foot goes on there, the dampers come off, we're going to sing as loud as we can, and then I will cut you off, and then with your bionic ears, listen for the faint resonance as it comes out here. Here we go. Nod your head if you can hear it. Yeah. Let's do it one more time. Here we go. Deep breath in. I hope you can hear that. Isn't this an amazing example of how to move and inspire people to take action? You find a note that resonates with them, and you sing it with all your heart. And maybe this is how ideas resonate. This was not an echo. It was the strings singing along with your voices. Let's say your voice was an idea being shared with this piano. Because the dampers were lifted, the strings were open to resonate with something that moved them. Because the dampers were lifted, the strings were able to add their sound, their energy, back into the mix. Resonance builds energy. So, let's take a minute to see how to best lift the dampers that keep us from resonating. Again, pretend that you're this piano with a complete set of dampers. Oh, look, there's anger, anxiety, apathy, the list goes on and on and on. And so my first job when I walk out on stage as a performer is to persuade you, the audience, to lift your dampers so that you may resonate with the music more deeply. When this happens, we enter into a state of dadiri, a deep spiritual act of reflective and respectful listening. This is from the Aboriginal culture. I'm working with my fourth graders on it, and you can imagine how that's going. And that's why I teach them meditation. Meditation is one of the greatest ways to improve dadiri, your inner musical experience. Why? Three reasons. Meditation quiets the mind and opens the heart. Meditation allows us to see which damper pedals are on, like negativity and depression or discouragement, and helps us to let them go. And finally, meditation allows us to create a sacred space inside for the experience of human resonance. Now, how many of you have done a meditation or mindfulness before? Isn't it true that when you begin, there's often a lot of fear that when you go within, there's going to be nothing there, nobody home? Maybe the strings of our soul will be horribly out of tune or even broken. That's where sweet music comes to the rescue. Many of us resonate with music that awakens brightness within. And that is what we want to take into meditation. And that is what I would like you to experience now. I'm going to lead you through a relaxation before I play another piece that I hope will resonate with you. And after that, we're going to see how the experience of resonance has changed our voices. So let's begin. Go ahead and sit upright with a balanced, relaxed spine. Roll your shoulders up and back. And we'll begin with even count breathing. We'll inhale through the nose for a count of four, hold for a count of four, and exhale for a count of four, like this. Inhale. Gently hold. And slowly exhale. Slowly inhale. Gently hold. And slowly exhale. One more time. Inhale. Gently hold. And slowly exhale. Now, as you continue watching the breath with eyes open or closed, begin to observe the motion of your chest and abdomen. Begin to feel the air as it flows in and out. Begin to feel space between your thoughts, space between your breaths. Allow yourself this opportunity to gently release any dampers within. Begin to feel a space of inner freedom. As you inhale, allow that space to expand. As you exhale, relax more deeply into it. Watch and feel what happens in that space as I play this next piece. Space. Give yourself permission to feel and enjoy any change within. Perhaps it's a spark, a vibration, a feeling, or an energy that wasn't there before. There is no right or wrong way to feel, except for what rings true for you. Invite that feeling to expand. The more deeply you allow yourself to feel, the greater your resonance will become. Start small with what is real. Allow it to grow. Notice that this feeling does not come from the outside. It comes from within. It was a string waiting to resonate. That string is a part of you. It's a part of your truth. Now, experience your voices infused with resonance. Notice how this practice has relaxed your heart, your breath, and your throat, creating the perfect space for resonance to take root. Please hum and sing with me one more time. Ma. Can you hear the difference? Can you feel the difference? Let's pull this into everyday life. Think of all the opportunities we have to share resonance. At work, dive into your mission statement and resonate the inspiration behind it. Serve others with life resonating inside of you. Build relationships with your dampers off. Create a genuine resonance of trust. And now, imagine yourself surrounded with people resonating not with fear or anger, but with their own positive soul vibration. This is how we inspire each other, by resonating within and sharing our truth. Many years ago, my teacher told me to look into my heart, and I'll admit, it's an unfinished business. But I invite you to take this next step with me. Let's lift our dampers, resonate with our brightness, and share that in everything we do. Words can't explain the kind of connections we can forge with this resonance. We need your resonance. We need your truth. Thank you.